Hey everyone, this is Nick from Mecha Warehouse, and today we're back with weekly update number 48. Okay, so anyway, let's jump right into it with the week in review. This is where I talk about what's been going on this week, things that are coming up, stuff like that. And I guess the first topic for today is a big thank you. Last week's restock, that huge restock we had last week, actually happened to be our second biggest day ever to date. So it's always awesome when we hit those kind of large milestones. We have those big, super impressive, like extra special days. Friday was crazy packing. Monday was crazy packing. We had a few things bleed over to Tuesday just because of the number of orders that we had come in, which is a good problem to have, I guess. We got caught up pretty quick, but it was a big day. So thank you for anybody who participated in that. Hopefully you all managed to get some great items. There were some awesome kits in last week's restock, and it just was an exciting weekend for me, for the business, and things like that. Thank you. Also, so a couple other things to talk about this week, not a ton, but tomorrow, at least tomorrow from when this is released, Saturday, September 25th, is the Builder Showcase, an open house here at Mecha Warehouse. I'm super excited. Doors will be opening at 2, give or take, and I'm excited to welcome many of you, or at least some of you, who might be local or willing to take the drive. We're going to have tables set up. We're going to get to see people's builds. I brought a couple of my own in yesterday to get them here and have them ready. And I'm just really excited for this event. I think it'll be a lot of fun, hopefully. And it'll be a lot of fun. And I'm looking forward to it. So hopefully we'll see you then. Also, we published this week a video with some tips. I talked to Justinius Builds and Nickel Models, or more accurately, I asked them to send me some footage for some clips that might be helpful for somebody who's participating in the Mecha Warehouse Presents Repaired contest. And they gave us some stuff. The first of those videos went out this past Tuesday. We have some more footage for some, I think, kit bashing related topics that will probably be a video for next week. So keep an eye out for that. And if you happen to watch either of those videos, either the one in the past or you watch the one next week, feedback would be great. This is our first time ever attempting to take footage that somebody else shot and kind of massaging it to be a video here on the Mecha Warehouse YouTube channel. And I would love feedback because I know that we learned a ton in the process of doing it about how we would do things differently for next time. But it'd be great to hear from you on the other end of things, how we might be able to do that better for next time. That's, I think, basically it for week in review. So let's move on to pre-orders. We added two new pre-orders to the site this week. Nothing super crazy. Both Mega House items. One is a Char statue, kind of a pricey item, but if you are a Char fanatic, it might be worth taking a look at. And the other is, let me look this up so I get the right name here. They're the Mega House GMG Earth Federation Forces number 4 through 6. We're only selling the set. We decided not to get the individual pieces. There didn't seem to be as much interest when we gauged interest on the Discord in the individual ones. We're giving some of these figures and things like that kind of a test run with this. Another really kind of pricey item, but cool if you're into collecting figures. And I guess apparently the set comes with the parts required to set up like a Gundam cockpit or something, so kind of cool. And the third pre-order is one we didn't put on the website, but there is a helmet, a Char helmet that Mega House is putting out as well. This is a really pricey, like $500-something item. We don't plan on just ordering some as a blanket order, but if you let me know that you want one, we can potentially order you one and get that for you. So feel free to email me, nick@mechawarehouse.com, DM me, whatever, sometime by like mid-October, because we'll be placing that order close to that deadline based on what people want for that. So that's it for pre-orders. Let's move on to restocks. I think restocks is going to be a a lot of stuff to talk about this week. So first and foremost, the first thing I want to talk about is the Mecha Warehouse lapel pin. They finally came in. We started shipping out the pre-orders, or at least the pre-orders that didn't have other items attached to them. But we do have extras of these, and these will be going up on the website for Friday. So kind of came out really good, in my opinion. I'm super happy with them. If you want one, they are up on the website. Now, as for kits, we got a lot of kits in this week. Some stuff that's been delayed. Some stuff that came in, just lots of variety. So let's start at the top of this massive pile here. So first up, full armor unicorn, real grade. This is a great kit. I've built it. We only got a few of those. I expect them to sell out really fast because we didn't get a very deep stock for whatever reason. They didn't have many available. We also got a ton of Build Divers stuff. Build Divers Re-Rise, fake new weapons, fake new unit, and then a lot of the other planet system stuff. Mercuon weapons, V2 weapons, Mars 4 weapons. Mercuon unit. I feel like there's some other ones that maybe I'm missing over here. They'll probably show up deeper in the pile here. The high-grade Alice Earth 3, kind of a cool design. Love the whole core Gundam concept and the evil kind of core Gundam kind of look like here is a pretty cool idea as well. We also got the real grade tall geese. We've got tons of these. This is as part of our effort to get a deeper stock of a lot of items. The real grade tall geese is definitely in that category. We managed to snag a bunch of them, so we'll hopefully have them in stock for a while. It's supposed to be a really nice kit, so this is a good opportunity to grab one if you want. Mobile doll May, we got that in as well. Another re-rise kit. Switching gears a little bit, Pokemon, we got the Mewtwo. SD Unicorn. And while we're on SDs, we got a few other SDs as well. The SD G Gundam. SD Command Gundam. We had these in stock, but we got some more in, replenishing our stock. That one's pretty cool. My son's built that one. SD, this is Delta Plus. SD Delta Plus. Another Build Divers Re-Rise. Diver IMA. People have been asking about IBO stuff. We got a couple IBO kits. Specifically the high-grade Kimaris Vidar and the master-grade Barbatos. Glad to have this one in stock. We had this very well stocked for a long time in the past, and we got a bunch in. Those I think were like 2 weeks late due to hurricane issues. Back to Re-Rise, we also got the Re-Rising Gundam. This is like basically the whole team from Build Divers Re-Rise, but merged together. I think it's essentially just the gold colors of those kits and parts to connect them together. Kind of a interesting idea. I think we have a few other Build Divers Re-Rise kits. Saturnix, I think, came in. And there's probably another one. So if you are into that stuff, I would definitely take a look because there's probably stuff I missed. We got a lot of kits in. We also got a paint restock, Mr. Color, Mr. Hobby stuff. The only like new items we got from that were these pastels, the Weathering Pastel Set 1 and 2. So if you are looking for, looks like one's like earthy tones and one is more like rust and metal tones, I guess. And so if you're into weathering. Those might be useful, maybe part of your repaired contest entry. We also got a small Disbay restock in. So the restock this week for Disbay, we ordered this stuff well before the last restock that we received. So quantities weren't necessarily able to be based on, you know, how well things sold last time. So for example, we've got the mixers as well as the pen sanders back in again. And we didn't manage to get a ton of these because the ordered quantities were before last time. So I expect they'll probably sell super fast again like they did with the last restock. We'll get more in a few months when the next restock comes in. Yeah, worth checking out. We also got more vices, and a lot of the other stuff is restocked from Disbay. And I think that's basically all we got for Disbay restocks this week, or restocks in general this week. So let's move on to Q&A. So Q&A is the part of the weekly update where I answer questions from you, the viewer, questions about Mecha Warehouse, about Gunpla, about, you know, me, about business, whatever you want to ask about. So we got a few questions this week. If you want to ask a question, best way to do that is to post a comment down in the, or post your question down in the comments below, and I will do my best to answer it next week. So I think we've only got two this week. First one, Ick5353 says, Nick, with the good sign of the massive restocks of the Sazabi Ver Ka, do you think there will be a reprint / restock of the Sinanju Ver Ka anytime soon? This is an excellent question. So first off, I want to say that I think you should not consider the Sazabi Ver Ka restock different in any way other than the fact that we were lucky to be able to see a bunch of extras that were available. Most likely, they either ordered a bunch more than they had commitments for, and so they brought in a ton extra in order to fulfill those commitments, or a large store decided they no longer wanted them and they, you know, ended up available not for grabs. So it doesn't necessarily mean that they're producing more or anything like that. It just might mean that they happen to have more on hand. So I don't know that that actually influences the Sinanju Ver Ka. That said, I think the Sinanju Ver Ka was on the order form for the end of the year this year. My memory is not 100% on that. I'll be finding out what is coming in for the end of the year probably next week. So we'll hopefully get word on what those restocks are, as well as how many we're getting, and be posting up the next set of pre-orders, things like that. So I'm hopeful that we'll be getting it soon. I think it's a fairly popular kit, so it'd be good to have it come back around again. Okay, the one other question, Dolomite 000 asks, do you know anything about the Nike SB X Bandai collaboration SD Gunpla? I know the shoes are releasing September 27th at 10 a.m. I heard it was a pre-order for China, but nothing from any U.S.-based shops. I really want to get that. So I've heard about this. Apparently Nike and Bandai are doing some sort of collab. There's like a Gundam-themed Nike sneaker and a Nike-themed Gundam or something that are going to be available. We definitely won't have the shoes because we don't carry shoes here. And I don't think we'll have the Gundam either. I think it's a P-Bandai release from everything I've heard. We don't do P-Bandai. You can go check out our video that I put out over a year ago about why we don't do P-Bandai. If you want to know more about that. But we don't do P-Bandai stuff. We don't tend to do limited release kind of stuff. And I don't think they're going to be sending it out to stores by default, and I don't like playing that reseller kind of game. So that's all I really know about that. It's an interesting idea, the whole collaboration shoe, sneaker, Gundam thing. It'll be interesting to see what other stuff they do like that over the coming years. But that's about all I know about that. So with all that said, if you have a question, like I said before, post it down in the comments below. I would love to answer it. And otherwise, I guess I will see you next time, or I'll see you tomorrow. So see you next time. Out.